Get out of here.
Okay, we might have some like fun folks on YouTube. I've never done YouTube, though, I don't think. What up, Peach? Hey, Chaos Embodied.
That's me. I think I just saw
Matt.
It's Chaos Embodied.
Ooh, that's a vibe.
My favorite chord.
There's a filter or something. I just look
maybe
orange.
Got no filter.
I just look orange all over. Looking great over here. Nope, there's zero and zero. We got 52 folks over here on TikTok. What's up, y'all? Y'all say hey as you're hopping on. I got my boy Paul Sikes with me tonight. It's going to be so, so fun. He co-wrote all of the songs y'all love with me and then produced my EP that comes out this Thursday.
Yeah, that's awesome. I'm excited and I'm terrified right now.
Yeah, he loves to be in front of the camera. He loves social media. He is a social guru, some might say.
It's going to be a special episode for all involved.
I'm going to embarrass the shit out of him for an hour, probably. It's very easy to do. Anyways, just giving people time to hop on. But again, if it's your first time here, let us know. This is Mayday Monday. I go live every Monday, and Paul tunes in religiously.
Religiously for the first time. Yes.
This guy said he's never watched my Mayday Mondays. What the hell, y'all? Y'all start shaming him in the comments.
I'm asking for forgiveness live. It's all good.
He is going to earn his friendship card back for me by participating in Mayday Monday tonight. So, yeah, if you got questions about EP, we are celebrating all things EP. My first EP, Paul produced it, made it exactly what it is. It's the coolest thing in the whole world, and we can't wait for y'all to hear it. We feel like we've been sitting on it for 6 years, 7 years.
Some of these songs are
10 years.
Good. Well, yeah.
It feels like it's been forever, but we're so excited to get it out. Should we start with a song we wrote together?
Yep.
You want to play I Quit Smoking with
me?
Oh,
yeah.
I'm gonna be huge one day.
It's our rehearsal.
Do you agree?
Yeah.
Paul also agrees I'm gonna be huge because he could make a lot more money doing other things than producing my EP, but he's believed in me from the jump. Please cover Casey Tindall. That's because I have a Casey Tindall shirt on, baby. I roll with Jesus and rock with Joan Jett. Hey, she's even more of a badass, pregnant, getting ready for tour. Let's go. Okay, anyways, this whole vibe of I Quit Smoking, if y'all haven't heard it, you got to go check it out. It was a single release. It's also on the upcoming EP. He did the craziest stuff with harmony. Like, it was mind-blowing. Even from when I left and had heard vocals and you added harmony, I was like, this is too cool to have my name on it. But anyways, and we were drunk the whole ride.
We were buzzing pretty good.
You were drunk You and Brett had beat me and I was trying to chug me some beer to catch up. Yeah, Jess has heard it.
Caught
Let's
up you
go.
Did.
And
that stuff you rolling.
Yes.
I'm just gonna read random words.
Anyways, so we're gonna play it for you. Go check it out if you like what you hear. And this is the man behind the madness. Producer Paul Sikes, hit songwriter. Y'all are in for a treat. And he's so happy to be here.
There was a time I was pushed and I'm full of storm.
talking kind, not a ritual. Caught a buzz, got you falling just because. But I've been down that road and I know just where it's going. Those hearts are claps.
Claps.
Throw us some hearts if you're having a good time. This is Paul's first time to TikTok Live.
Yeah.
So, Paul is a producer, which means he doesn't leave his studio very much. His studio is on the basement floor of his house. So, I had to just roll up in here 10 minutes till 7 and be like, Paul, get ready. We are going live on TikTok.
I was like, is this a video? What is happening?
We're trying to pretend like it's not so he doesn't get uncomfortable, but it's fine. What up? We're on YouTube too. I should have shared these to my socials, but I didn't have time. We are going to post this back so you can go watch this on my YouTube after. If for some reason you didn't get to catch the whole thing and missed the beginning, custom leather straps.
I'm in the market.
Awesome. Yeah. Y'all say hey. Anyways, this is Paul's first time on MAEDAY Monday, so we are throwing him in the deep end. Maddie is obsessed with my cover of Don't Close Your Eyes. I know you loved him. You could play this way prettier than I can. A long time ago. And even now in my still want him, I know. Christina said, welcome to Maniac Nation. Darling, this time your memories die. When you hold me tonight, don't close your eyes. Don't close your eyes. Darling, just once, let yesterday go. You'll find more love than you've ever known. Just hold me tight when you love me tonight. Don't close your eyes. Little bit of that one. Thanks for the request.
Double wide or recycled. Paul, I think you might have came after my double wide days.
Yeah.
Do you remember that song? Have you ever played it with me?
I've never played it with you, but I do remember it.
Yes, we love you too. Jolien. Thanks for the request, Maddie. So I do want to talk to Paul a little bit. Like I said, we're going to watch this back. Y'all can share the live to invite people in. I saw a few comments saying, why are there not that many people here? Which we don't care about it. We're happy to have anyone who wants to sit
probably
down and hang with
us. Probably saw me on the bill.
On a Monday. Paul has probably heard our viewer numbers. But send us hearts that lets us know you are there hanging out. And it shows interaction for us. And then if you want to share the live to your Facebook, Instagram, all those things. Encourages people to come and hang out. We would love to get as many people in as we can while I brag about my producer who produced my first EP coming out this week. If you haven't pre-ordered and pre-saved that sucker, it's in every bio I have. You can't miss the link. You really cannot miss it. Just Google me. It's fine. Go get it automatically added to your library wherever you listen to music, and I think you're going to love it. We worked really hard on it. We cut vocals right here behind me. Made a lot of magic. This is where a lot of the magic happened. Not all of it. That was a different studio. But but the vocal magic happened here where I burped in the mic a lot. And Paul told me I did a good job. Over
the burping was incredible.
He's very nice.
Heard a lot of burps. A
lot of burps. I have one of the top tier burps.
The pitch was incredible.
Well... You know, I have one skill.
One skill.
So how did you get to Nashville? Like, what's your music journey, Anna? Not at all uncomfortable story. In a totally relaxed, not at all uncomfortable story.
Well, since you asked, I was hoping you would ask. waiting for that question. No, I've known May now for 5 years? 4 years?
Too long.
Well, I was born in Nashville. I was born here, grew up in a town called Clarksville, Tennessee, which is like 45 minutes up the road, and that's where I grew up. And then, you know, I didn't grow up in the business or anything, but grew up playing guitar. Do I look at you, or where do I look?
Here, you can talk to me. It's more uncomfortable, I think, if you make eye contact.
So, and then, like, what happened was, I've just been growing up playing music.
It's kind of rare. Nashville's such a transplant town, so for people that haven't spent a lot of time in Nashville, we call, like, the people that were born and raised in Nashville who are still here and do the music, we kind of call them unicorns. But the longer I've been here, the more I meet.
There's unicorns
Nashville natives, but they are still kind of like a special thing because you've been in it from the get-go.
Yeah, I mean, my dad was a preacher. It still is. My mom was a teacher, retired a few years now. But so I didn't know it was an avenue I could take, but I did grow up playing and loving it.
Did they write that Randy Travis song about your family?
I wish.
You have a farmer and a hooker in your...
There's a few hookers.
Close family also.
Not that I know of. There's probably a few closet hookers running around there somewhere.
They ain't closeted in my family, homie.
No way.
You and I have written songs about them.
That's right.
That's the thing about your co-writers.
First one was.
They get to know you very well. Because you gotta really go deep. But anyways, you loved music, and you're kind of like a freaking prodigy, right? When did you start your first instrument, and what was it?
Piano was my first instrument. It started at 7. I picked up guitar at 14. Then I picked up Pro Tools.
And that's like, when you started making money.
Yeah, finally. But no, it's just been a journey. I figured out I wanted to go chase being a songwriter. I fell in love with Don Williams. It was my first love.
Come on! Music. What's your favorite song?
There's a song called Country Boy that's... I ain't gonna marry in the fall, I ain't gonna marry in the spring. It's just a beautiful song. He's baritone, but also, Lord, I Hope This Day Is Good is probably his most famous song that is also one of my favorites.
And Liam may or may not have recorded it, put it on that.
It's his voice. I just fell in love with his voice. And like...
Oh, it's so easy.
Yeah, so easy. Giant. Just fell out. And I'm not a baritone, but his voice just really kind of made me fall in love with country. And I just kind of
James loves
songs.
Country Boy.
Country Boy, let's go.
James, you have a pal in Paul Sikes.
Let's go.
Your first TikTok friend.
Yeah.
James Mason.
I got that album for my 21st birthday, his greatest hits.
Like a vinyl?
No, it was just a CD.
Like
but
an 8-track?
No, it was just straight up CD. My dad was like, you need to hear this.
I'm just joking about your age.
Oh, that. Yeah.
Okay. He's also a vampire. You never know how old he is.
Cassette tapes.
He's more mature than I am. That's all that counts.
Barely. Just on here because I'm scared. I'm scared.
Yeah, because, look, so you got a CD.
CD.
But you live in cassette tape prom. Like, growing up?
Record
the radio and shit like
that? I did. I grew up recording the radio. And me and my sister used to do a little radio show where we record songs off the radio and act like we're a DJ team.
That is my favorite thing in the whole world. What's your sister's name?
Her name's Laura, but her radio name was Lori Gates for some weird reason.
Bro, I hosted a radio show as part of my degree in college, and I could not think of a DJ name.
Like Lori Gates coming to you, doing the Madison Street Minute, and we have all the gossip for you.
The Madison Street Minute? Are you kidding?
It's amazing.
Okay, where are these files?
We have magazines that she made.
Okay, why is she not running my marketing team?
I don't know.
My first question.
Because she's doing accounting in Indiana. I need to get her down here for
To
run the May Empire.
No kidding. She sounds like an evil genius from way back.
She's a smart one.
First album was Tim McGraw. Y'all let us know what your first albums to purchase were. I have no idea. I have no idea what my first album would have been. But that kind of was like, I was on LimeWire at a pretty young age, stealing all of my music. The Coyote Ugly soundtrack was for sure early.
Oh, yeah.
Leanne Rimes blew my whole ass mind. Remember those days? You're pretty sure yours was Loretta Lynn, Gretchen Wilson. This all makes sense as to why y'all are in my live stream. I think we can make...
Oh, that's cool.
Gretchen Wilson. Oh, Jordan said Martina for me, probably. That's my little sister.
Oh, really?
Yes. Reba McEntire. Can't remember which one. They're all good.
Oh, Reba's on here? Hey, Reba.
My close personal friend. Shania Twain first album. Like, the one where she's in, like, Alaska and has got, like, a fur coat on. Or my favorite, which was technically her second. I need to know. Storms of Life, Randy Travis. Come on. Jordan said, hey, Paul, can't wait to meet you at the Opry.
Let's go. I will be there.
So that's another thing. I'm getting to make my Opry debut. I'm thinking about cheating. And I'm thinking this new song that y'all haven't heard yet until the EP comes out called Town Left Me.
I'm going to cry.
I don't know. It's pretty special.
Did you get three?
No. Good. I mean, I'm super grateful. For my two.
Calling and complaining.
But yeah, we thought it was three, and it's two. So it's extra hard to get to pick only two songs to introduce yourself to the country music community in this way. But yeah, we're going to play this one you haven't heard yet. It's coming out Thursday, technically Wednesday at midnight. We're going to do a live stream countdown. Paul will not be there. He will be recovering from this live stream. Still trying to get that anxiety down. But... we are so proud of this song. We wrote it right here in this room with Autumn McIntyre. I brought in this line about visiting home. Actually, how do you remember how this song came to be? Town Left Me is what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Do you remember that day?
Yeah, I do remember the day. I remember you talking about coming back to the place, and it felt like it was... I'm getting choked up already. Oh, my God.
You laugh.
I just remember the hook kind of, we didn't have the hook quite yet, but we had the idea of, like, going back to the town that, like, it's just kind of changing, you feel like a different person, or, like, it's just not how you remember it, and it kind of just organically fell from the sky.
I remember you were the one that ended up making the hook work with, I know I'm the one that left this town, but it feels more like this town left me, because you're really good at, like...
We actually wrote that at my house across the street.
Did we?
Yeah.
Oh, shit, I'm lying.
It was before we got here, before I got here.
Really?
Because that song's over 2 years old now.
You're just going to call me out on my live stream with these lies?
It's called a lie stream, apparently.
Oh, my gosh.
No, I just remember I remember the hardwood floor and sitting there in that little... I just remember where I was. When we,
wow.
Yeah. It's been a minute.
It really has. And one of my publishers who I'm incredibly lucky to work with, Stephanie Cox... who's been a great friend and mentor and just...
She's my mama. Not really, but I call her mama. She called me baby. And it's a beautiful relationship we have between mama and baby.
And HR should have been involved a long time ago. But anyways, she's an evil genius and she's gotten so many of our favorite songs cut like all of these artists and songs and things we're talking about. She has had a hand in so many of those getting to our ears. Hey, when's my Grand Ole Opry debut? It is March 4th. Hey, YouTube. Sorry, we forgot about you a little bit. We're over here on TikTok also. We're talking about a song that's coming out on my brand new EP this Thursday. It's released everywhere, and this is the song y'all haven't gotten to hear fully produced yet anyways, called Town Left Me, that we're talking about. But anyways, yeah, I just remember being so, so special, and my publisher, Stephanie, was like, everybody has a town song.
You that's right. When I told you that? I do.
I came back to my co-writers, Paul and Autumn, and was like, listen, she's just like, this is another town song, and there's a million of them. And then it took, I don't know, probably a year, maybe. And she was finally like, I've been listening to that song nonstop, and it makes me cry every time I hear it. And I was like, we got through her.
We got her. We got you, Steph. Still just a town song, Steph.
Still just a town song, but it's our town song, and it's so special. And we're going to play it for you. By we, I mean me, probably. Bless your feeling first,
kid. Yeah.
What do I play this one?
You don't need me.
Oh. I don't need you or any man, but I want you around, PP. That's what I want. Also, I call him PP for producer Paul. We got to get that out of the way because it's going to come out. Producer Paul. Average, normal sized.
Oh, God.
You're an average height, right?
Yeah.
That's 5'6"
yeah.
No, I mean, how tall are you? 5'11"?
5'11". I never got the 6 foot mark. I tried, but it didn't happen.
Oh, that's so sad.
It is.
All right, this is a sad song. I don't know if we... Can y'all hear us? We're good? I haven't seen a comment in a minute. We good? We good? Somebody... Oh. I just closed you. Somebody comment and let me know you can still hear us. Anybody? Okay, well, we're gonna start this song and hopefully you can hear us. Almost missed the turn of my mama's head. Just looking around at all the things that have changed since I rolled out. That brand new coffee shop used to be a gravel lot. It was the home game hangout spot. Now it's not. It's real clear to see. With or without me. Yeah, it says my TikTok stopped working. All right. We're going to close out. I was wondering why we had 9 people.
Wonder why no one likes us anymore.
Wonder why no one likes us.
Wait, is this door on?
Yeah, this is our song.
Hey.
Hey. We got 8 folks. Y'all comment and say, hey, what's up? This is my first time to YouTube. Maybe my second time to YouTube live. I'm probably lying. I don't do it very often, though. I'm trying to end.
Trying to end it all.
Trying to end my TikTok because it ain't working no more. All right. Way to let me down. I should be on your Wi-Fi.
Yeah.
All right. We're going to try this again. 9 people on YouTube. Okay, let's give it a second. We were rolling through that sucker. Hey, I had a pesto sandwich for lunch and I feel it in the air.
I just swallowed the pesto sandwich.
All right, we got Jessica back. All right. Sorry, y'all had a missed connection of some sort. I got a text from my mom and sister, who are my OGs, that watch. What's the first song you learned on guitar? That's pretty cool.
Team Spirit, baby.
Y'all say hey when you hop on. Make sure we got this thing rolling again. I had to get off and get back on. Somebody give me a comment and we're gonna play that song coming out on the EP. All right, we got a comment. Let's go. All right, sorry, we were in the middle of this one. We lost connection. If that happens again, let me know. It was fire, but we will start it again. Almost missed the turn of my mama's house. Just looking around, all the things that have changed since I pulled out. That brand new coffee shop used to be a gravel lot. It was the home game hangout spot, and now it's not. And it's real clear to see. Glad y'all love that one because it's coming out on my debut EP.
Let's go!
This Thursday. Thank you, Mike. Mike Livingston.
That's... Chills.
Yes, chills.
She's singing good.
Mike said we're singing good. Thank you, Mike. Mike's a, he's a regular. He's every Monday here.
Heck yeah.
Rusty, thank you so much, y'all. You want to do Stubborn Will?
Oh, actually, gosh, yeah.
Actually, I want to hear what your favorite song we've written together is.
My favorite song we've written together. I mean, Town Left Me is truly up there.
Town Left Me and Stubborn Will are the only songs you can think of that we've
No, Pedal Steel is one of my favorites.
So, Pedal Steel is one we were also debating at the Opry. My only thing is I'm scared to play it at the Opry and not
also
have it released.
Also, Raise a Baby.
Dude, let's do Raise a Baby. Let's do something while we never get to do it.
Yeah.
I don't know how to play it.
I don't know how to sing it, so I'll play if you want to sing it. Do you know the words?
Yep. You know my brain is only lyrics, right? All intelligence is gone. Jordan said I love Pedal Steel so much. Brittany loves Stubborn Will. Hey, Tim. Happy to have you.
Hey, Tim.
Hey, I know I sound like an idiot, but I'm really just genuinely excited. You have to just start realizing that people, these usernames are people, and then it feels way less weird.
Have I met Jordan before? Name rings a bell, I don't know.
Baby J, have you met Paul before?
So you know the words?
Yeah.
Okay.
That feels like, is that the right chord? I mean, key?
By the
time you, okay.
Yes.
Okay,
close.
Let's roll.
Yeah.
This is one y'all may or may not have heard. It's not released, but it is Paul's Pride and Joy. And I'm really proud to be a part of it too, honestly. By the time you turn 25, need a house on a hill, minivan, and a drive with a stick figure family on the back, with a wraparound picking and a welcome mat. Yeah, that'd make mama happy. But you call me the black sheep, cause I'd rather raise a glass than a baby. Rather be a legend than a lady. I like my Friday nights free, my bottom shelf neat. It's hard enough taking care of me. Rather raise a glass than a baby. He's hiding. I can't say I won't come around.
Yeah.
When the dust I'm picking up settles on down, I'm working on my own timeline, pouring every last drop out of my prime. So I put a quarter in a jukebox and another when it stops. I'd rather raise a glass than a baby. Rather be a legend. Friday nights free, my bottom shelf me. It's hard enough taking care of me. Lately, no ifs, ands, and maybes. I'd rather raise a glass than a baby, baby. Is that a bridge? Okay, I'm still pretty far from standing in the yard, balloon popping pink or blue. Ooh, how the hell y'all afford having two under four with the bills and the mortgage too? I ain't got a clue. Well, I'd rather raise a glass than a baby. Rather be a legend than a lady. I like my Friday nights free, my bottom shelf neat. It's hard enough taking care of me. Legend than a lady. I like my Friday nights free, my bottom shelf neat. It's hard enough taking care of me. Baby, no ifs, ands, and maybes. I'd rather raise a glass, so come on, raise a glass. If you'd rather raise a glass than a baby, baby. Baby.
I'd rather raise a glass than a baby. I should have stopped that.
Baby.
Here it goes.
A better grass than a baby.
Also, Half an Acre comes to mind.
You're going to have to give me a little more telepathic connection on what you thought we were going to do.
Well, if you would have had me earlier, then...
Mike said his four kids are why he drinks. Mike, I get that, buddy. And we wrote that song for you.
For you, Mike.
Christina has three kids, but she would blast this. Yes, girl. Definitely Opry worthy. I don't know, dude. It's pretty fun, though. Half an Acre. Oh, man. We could play our favorite songs together all night long. I love that song, too. Let's do Stubborn Wheelwar together for sure.
Let's do it.
How's your time? You feel great?
Me?
Yeah.
Yeah. I feel really good about everything.
Mm. Sorry, I got a text. When is this going to be available? That song, I'm not sure. It's a perfect song for Priscilla Block, so I keep pushing it to her. I would probably record it at some point. I don't know that it will make my first record. I'll be honest with you. Loves Run. Paul was a writer on Run, too. I forgot that. That's not our, like, heaviest content of a song, but it is still done really well.
I will
say
I've gotten a whole lot of text from that about that song, personally. Okay. Probably the most of... ours that we have, at least.
Yeah, it's gotten a lot of hype. I'm excited for a lot of these other songs that kind of just got, like, dropped without a lot of marketing to get another push, too. Because I think, like, I Quit Smoking is one of my smaller streaming songs, but I think it's a freaking vibe. It's just got to get to its people.
I agree.
But Run is a vibe. It's probably my vibiest so far. And we did some cool stuff where he had me, like...
sing
things completely out of my era. That, like, Like, that's so cool. That's when you were telling me what to do, I was like, what?
What are you talking about?
And we went back and forth on the, Well, I did. You were probably, like, sure of it the whole time.
I felt good about it.
But I was like, I don't know.
But thank you for going with it.
No, that's my husband's favorite thing, is the, Every song we have is awesome. We want to come to Columbus, Ohio. Run is Christina's favorite, Paul. Yes, windows down. I quit smoking. I jammed that sucker on the way into town today. Okay, so we're going to do Stubborn Will.
Let's try it.
If you're just now hopping on, say hey, this is Paul Sikes. He is a great friend, a co-writer, a hit songwriter, and the producer of my upcoming EP that releases this week. Link in bio if you want to go pre-ad, pre-save, pre-order, pre-hype yourself.
Pre-game.
You are a natural at this. This is Paul's first live stream. TikTok live. Maybe not live stream, but probably up there. And so he's doing a lot better since we started. But I will, like, clip out our bloopers and make it look like you had a terrible time.
That's good. I am a blooper, so.
Oh, Paul is the best. He's the nicest dude in town. You will not hear a bad word about the dude in Nashville, and he was born here, so that's saying something. He's been nice his whole life, y'all. That's something. I really only started trying to be nice in the last, like, 3 years.
There's always time to F it up, but here we go.
What up, Josh? Leanne? You love roses. Hey, Logan. Paul is chill. Logan said you're chill.
Thanks, Logan.
Okay, we might have to close with roses. Right now, I want y'all to hear this song that is so, so special that I got to be a part of and that Paul brought the idea on and was... You're doing great, PP. SJ McDonald!
SJ in the house?
SJ in the house! Anyways, Paul pitched this idea. Do you want to say anything about... I feel like I get to introduce my songs all the time.
That's great. You should. No one wants to hear me.
No, I do. My 11-year-old doesn't get the meaning of the song, but she belts thinking about Jean like crazy. That's the kid... That's the one the kids gravitate towards.
She will get it one of these days.
Yeah, I just... I don't... I'm sorry, y'all. That's all I got to say. I don't know how to keep it away from the children, but if they learn direct communication in their marriages, then you can credit me for that. You can credit me for their divorces too, probably, but I'm a burden I'm willing to carry. You brought this idea.
Yeah, I just remember, I don't think I had much on it. I remember I just had the title and the concept of, like, I had the title Stubborn Will. What can we do with that? So I had this idea of, like, nothing will do this like Stubborn Will, and nothing will happen like Stubborn Will, and just wanted to kind of play off that, and I had nothing on it other than that concept, and we just...
And then I brought in my Jerry Springer life story.
Yeah,
The first line is, Daddy ain't talked to Grandpa in 10 years, and it's been way more than that, honestly. But yeah, I definitely have some estranged family that fit right into that idea perfectly, and I mean every word of this song when I sing it because, man, I relate. And I feel really lucky that you trusted me with that idea because that's something... I get really stingy with my ideas lately because I have my people. So if I'm in a room with Paul or Autumn or Josh Matheny or Marty, I just have these writers that I feel really safe with. And I'll pitch those ideas that feel really special, but you want to make sure it goes somewhere that you believe in. And so I feel really lucky that you trusted us with that.
No doubt.
And I'm ready to cut this sucker. Stat. This is Stubborn Will, unreleased. Daddy ain't talked to Grandpa in 10 years. They cut ties on what could have been settled over a couple beers. In the name of being right, they hang on to yesterday. Is it worth the wasted time playing a losing game? Nothing's gonna starve your soul. Feed your pride. Nothing's gonna build your walls up so damn high. Nothing's gonna burn that bridge and break a heart. Nothing's gonna keep you standing right where you are. Something's gonna cut so deep and shoot to kill, like stubborn will.
Mustache was a mustache.
I should know, cause that's what got me all by myself on the front porch, watching your taillights disappear. I'm sorry, would have gone a long way, but I'm learning the hard way. Nothing's gonna starve your soul or feed your pride. Nothing's gonna build your walls up so damn high. Nothing's gonna burn that bridge and break a heart. Nothing's gonna keep you standing right where you are. And nothing's gonna cut so deep and shoot to kill like stubborn. It sure was hard to call you up. I bet you didn't want to hear from me. But I'm trying to grow out of what I came out honestly. Nothing's gonna starve your soul or feed your pride. Nothing's gonna build your walls up so damn high. Nothing's gonna burn. Nothing's gonna keep you standing right where you are. And nothing's gonna cut so deep and shoot to kill like stubborn will. Like stubborn will.
On the live streams, we cheer for ourselves because it's quiet if not.
Weird, weird. Thought I was a good songwriter until I heard this LOL great song. Thank you, Sarah. I'm sure you are a great songwriter. We were just lucky to be in the room when that song came to be. Best country voice. Thank you. Thank you, Tim. I know. That is such a special song.
That's cool.
I'm 15 and got my first gig this weekend. First song I'm singing is Thinking About Cheating. Let's go, girl. Please post a video so we can cheer you on. Hey, Kentucky. That's so exciting. Can you remember being 15?
Yep.
If you're this awkward as a full-grown adult, what were you like at 15?
Oh, it was insane. It was not good.
I bet it was great, and I bet you were the most musically inclined 15-year-old. Oh, places I've never been, Mark Wills. Okay, can I please tell you, Mark Wills is playing the Opry when I'm playing the Opry, and I plan to make him my best friend. Oh, I love him so much. Do you know Mark Wills stuff?
A little bit. He had this one song that I freaking love so much, and I'm drawing a blank on it.
Bro.
It was a hit.
I bet I can play it. Almost Doesn't Count, he redid. Is that my... That's not what you're talking about. Was it upbeat?
No, it was mid, and I'm gonna look it up because it's driving me nuts.
Places I've been is so good. Places I've never been. Thanks, Carter. Marty now, Mark. Oh, don't laugh at me?
No.
Oh.
When you think of me. Remember that one?
I don't think so.
When you think of me, remember the time I met you. It was the melody. I just remember that song.
Oh,
was a soaring
I do.
Melody.
When you think me. Remember the way that it used to be. Remember the nights I held you tight.
Yeah. I remember loving that song so much.
Okay, well, I'm listening to that song on repeat on the drive home because I forgot all about that one. I don't know my favorite, but how does the chorus start on Places I've Never Been?
I don't remember that one as well to help out.
He just has such a great voice, and he still does. places I've never been.
It was 1970-something.
Thank you, Tommy. Yes, I did cry hysterically when I got asked to play. Hey, did you get your pick situation?
It's in my guitar.
Oh, okay.
I got another one.
Okay, cool. If you had to pick a favorite, what I did actually last time I played this, I did a random word generator, and you had to like sing a little bit of a song with that word in it. I feel like you'd be
a written that. Song or make up one.
No, like a song that's released that's like public.
I would not be good at that.
If I was like Will, you'd be like
Will the Circle.
No, that's not.
Be unbroken.
Wheel.
Wheel.
The Arkansas. Wagon wheel.
Yeah.
It's a pretty fun game. I forgot.
I would not be good at that. I'm not good. Remembering words is not my
strong point. I would not be good at that.
Wheel. The circle.
Something like that. I travel the world in your arms and back again. Right down here, I got a cut on Miss Julie Roberts, which is pretty damn cool.
That's super cool.
Because you take me places I've never been. Okay, I'm going to work that one up. Since you said this was one of your favorite songs, I grew up singing this song. Let's do Lord, I Hope This Day Is Good.
Let's go.
How do you want to know which drumming pattern? Because I have like one.
Lord, I hope
such an amateur guitar player, but I get by. Saw you at Bluebird first time and the basement and loved everything since. Heck yeah, thank you so much. Sing a song with the word blue in it. Blue, oh so lonesome for you. Why can't you be blue? Over me. I am not Leanne, but both Leannes taught me a lot. Leanne Rimes was doing a lot of classic country when I was listening to her. She had like a classic country record. So did Martina with Timeless. And that's where I learned a lot of like, pick me up on your way down when you're blue and all alone. When the glamour starts to boil, come on back where you belong. There's a lot of like super old ones. Okay, Lord, I hope this day is good. Is that a good key?
Sure.
Lord, I hope this day is good. I'm feeling empty and misunderstood. I should be thankful, Lord, I know I should. But Lord, I hope this day is good. Lord, have you forgotten me? I've been praying to you faithfully. I'm not saying I'm a righteous man, but Lord, I hope you understand. Fortune and I don't need fame. Send down the thunder, Lord, send down the rain. But when you're planning just how it will be, plan a good day for me. Lord, I hope this day is good. I'm feeling I should be thankful, Lord, I know I should, but Lord, I hope this day is good.
I think it's a break here.
Paul Sikes, y'all, give him some hearts. You've been the king since the dawn of time. All that I'm asking is
this day is good.
Yeah.
Pick us out. Anyways, that is some Don Williams. Lord, I hope this day is good. That's one of Paul's
all time.
All time.
What's happening to this wig?
It's getting swiggier. All right, what time is it? Oh, we're like 10 minutes from an hour.
You serious?
That feels
pretty good. Time flies when you're scared to death.
Don't it? Don't it? You gotta play one of your hits.
Really?
I mean, you don't have to.
I mean,
I support you. I'm not gonna mentally abuse you on camera. Please do some Womack. What's your favorite Womack song?
Favorite Leanne Womack song.
Womack.
Either way.
Well, let's fucking go, dude.
Either way,
let's sing it. You be my Stapleton.
Yeah.
He's my mutt. I say, that sounds really like my mutt Lang. I feel like me and Paul have the cool dynamic that Shania and Mutt did, but without the relationship and the divorce and the ugly cheating and things like that. It's way healthier if they would have just been friends.
It's a lot healthier, yeah.
A lot healthier. And then you just make great music together and cut up like your brothers, and it's so much more fun. I never promised you a rose garden. I've done that one a million times too. Okay, Paul said his favorite Leanne Womack song is Either Way, which a lot of people know is a Chris Stapleton song, because he wrote that and then released his own later. But Leanne Womack, it's like apples and oranges. I feel like comparing Chris Stapleton and Leanne Womack singing it, but both versions are incredible in their own right. And I know y'all saw Chris Stapleton slay that national anthem. What'd you think about that?
It just flows out of his mouth with the easiest. It's crazy. I don't even know what to say about it. I'm just kind of like, blah, blah, blah.
Well, that's what I've heard.
He's barely like moving. It just like comes out. It's just so beautiful. It's incredible.
And the taste, like the unique perspective on the way he does things. It's crazy. But I was talking to my friend Josh Matheny about it, and he was like, you know, he could have done way more. Like, he could have done his whole...
I wished he had just barely more, but it was so nicely... It was so good.
Yeah. It left you wanting more, which is probably the feeling. I bet he sells a lot more tickets this year, and I don't think he was hurting before the Super Bowl, so... Gonna be crazy. That's a tour I'm gonna manifest. I'm gonna be on that tour.
I can totally see that.
I'm totally going on the Stapleton tour. You're gonna have to come out.
Yeah.
You're gonna have to clear your schedule. Get out of your basement.
Consider it cleared.
Once again this year.
Yeah.
He had everyone crying. Okay, what were we about to do? Oh, Paul's favorite Leanne Womack song. This is going to be a new segment with my songwriters. Is y'all pick my artist, your favorite song from my favorite artist.
Oh, yeah, that lick.
It's one of three licks, I know.
It's good.
Thank you.
and hard, but hearts can only do that for so long. We can't just go on like this. Say the words, we'll call it quits. Baby, you can go. World today. The way this soothes my soul. Come on, come on, come on. Yes. We've never played that together. This is fun.
That was fun.
We're usually working together.
I almost wanted to go to the high one, but I got too scared.
You want to try again?
Nope.
Is someone still on here that wanted roses? If so, we'll end on roses. You got anything else you want to play? You don't want to play your hits, right?
This is your night.
He wrote,
That's right.
It's gonna make me want to. How's that chorus start?
Kind of like, girl, what's your name? What you drinking? Little Jimmy Allen.
What's your name? What you drinking? Hey, what's your favorite song? If you're thinking that I'm thinking, we ain't gonna be in this bar too long. We're thinking on that takeoff.
Yeah, they said we need roses.
And then, first, that was first number one, right?
Yep.
Second number one.
I've been from Savannah to Long Beach. Right. Everywhere but on.
I've been from Savannah to Long Beach, trying to keep your memory out of reach. There you were in the Delta. Santa Fe sun, Colorado sky. I could add another push pin to the map, but that don't stop me from missing you and looking back. Guess it's just one place I haven't gone. I moved everywhere but home. Mr. Matt Stell.
Right.
Everywhere but on. Second number one. Third number one. Town left me with May Estes.
Let's go.
Let's go.
I'll take it.
Something with May Estes.
It's going to happen.
Come on. I owe my songwriters a number one for sure. Greg said Everywhere But On kicks ass.
All right. Let's go.
Let's go. All right. Thanks for hanging out with us. This has been a special edition of Mayday Monday, which we do every Monday that I'm able to do it. Not a come hell or high water kind of thing. I just kind of like to live my life also, so I stopped putting the pressure on myself. I love that song too. Cindy, go get the EP. I know you already got a pre-order, girl. We're also printing CDs. Did I tell you that?
Let's go.
Yeah, they should be getting here anytime. So those will go up on my website eventually, but they are going to be at my Opry debut after party. So we are having a party at the Palace. If y'all are in town for that, come hang out. We're going to have a VIP section just so I can kind of spend time with my family too.
Nashville Palace?
Yes.
Yep.
So don't be offended if I'm trying to spend time with my family, but the whole state of Arkansas is coming to town, I swear. And we have the Palace open, but it's also open to the public. So we're going to be mixing and mingling and having an after party there if you are coming to town for that. And my boys, Old Hickory, are playing, and they are a killer trio in town. you will not care if I live or die after you hear them because it's all consuming. It is the best. And we're going to dance all night long, and I'm going to drink so many Red Bulls to stay up past
dance.
10 p.m. You don't listen to many artists because it's hard to sing along. Well, Greg, we got some sing-alongs. Absolutely. They are so good. There is also a live stream of the Opry, so don't worry. I'm going to set y'all up for success with all of the things. Sorry, my forehead itches, and this is a good way to scratch it. Okay, sorry. We're going to end with roses, right? That's what we're doing?
Roses.
This is what I do is get so distracted. Definitely getting a CD. Anyways, what I was going to say is that the after party will be the first time we'll have them for sale. So, if you want to buy my first CD ever, they'll be for sale and physical in person. I'll sign them, whatever you want, because I didn't pay to get the plastic wrap on them. That was extra.
No shrink wrap.
That seems fucking stupid. So, oh, sorry, my F word. I'm getting better at least knowing when I'm cussing. That's like a big jump for me.
That's a big jump.
That's pretty good. Okay. You have my pick. That's why I'm looking. I just use the tip of my nail and then it files it down to nothingness.
Yeah, that's what I do too. So, yeah.
Oh, no.
It happens.
Well, I can't do that. I have to be a girl.
I gotta be a girl.
Paint my nails. You see how long that lasts. All right. Thank y'all so much for hanging with me. Yes, girl. You're gonna be in the front row. Let's go. I can't wait. It's gonna be so exciting. I'm so, so lucky to have people around me that are just champs, and we're all celebrating this together. Paul is so excited, he can't even stand it.
I'm so excited I did this evening with May.
Yes, that's why. He did not cry. You got emotional-ish when I hugged you and I was crying hysterically, or you were just like, damn, bitch, you should get that together.
I was so excited, I don't even remember what happened tonight.
I just remember hugging you and being like, we did this!
We got it! It happened, mommy!
Like you're in my bubble. Paul kicks ass on everything, homie.
Thank you.
Jason Nix needs to be there. Jason will have to be a guest at some point because I love my boy Jason, but he's hard to nail down these days.
I just wrote with Jason the other day. He was so fun to be around.
Are you kidding? Dude is he's a great person to be around, but dude is a songwriter. Phew! Every song we've ever written together I plan on gutting. Unbelievable. Anyways, this was my anti-Valentine's jam that I released 2 years ago. Yesterday or the day before was its 2-year release anniversary. I don't even know. That feels so crazy. It's a special song. It was my first song to hit a million, which is a small number to a lot of people, but that's a big number if you're an independent artist. And I didn't pay nobody nothing to get me those streams, so it feels really, really cool that y'all just listen that much, or that my mom and grandmother did. Either way, it's pretty cool. And I just made that word up. Yeah, probably one of them. I don't know which one. Anyways, it's called Roses. It's out everywhere if you want to check it out. And the EP that me and this dude created before the record is coming out this Thursday. What's before the record mean to you, real quick? Just since we're on the EP theme.
Before the record, what does that mean to me?
Well, if you had to tell somebody about the project, like in just a little paragraph, what would you say about the project?
The word journey comes to mind.
Yeah.
Everything that you work for, and you hear this collection of songs, there's so much that happened before that in order for that to even be possible.
Absolutely.
I don't know if that's how you meant it, but that's what it says to me.
No, that's exactly how I meant it. That's what I've been telling people is like, it feels like I'm at a point in my career where there's this like line I'm about to cross over. And it feels, I mean, like the Opry's a great example of that, where it feels like I'm getting to play the Grand Ole Opry, which kind of just puts you in a different tier in your career, it feels like. I don't know if that's true, but it means so much to me that I kind of feel like I'm going to be making music with a lot less pressure on it. Because honestly, the Opry was like,
yeah,
that was it. So I can die happy after March 4th.
They're all milestones, so just
and that's
keep
the thing.
Them coming.
Yeah, there's a little bit of everything on here. I think there's something for everybody and different sounds with still like a consistency that is my voice in general, I think. But we kind of covered a lot of territory and production. We pushed the limits on some of them, which feels like pushed the limits to me because I'm pretty traditional. But I think we have a fresh thing. Like if you don't relate to the lyrics, which I hope that you do, and I feel like you definitely will on at least one song. I think the production is interesting enough where you want to listen to the whole project. Would you agree?
Yes, but not interesting enough to... No, I'm just kidding.
Not as interesting if it would have been a different producer. Right, but exactly. Paul was all I had access to, and it just...
You get what you get.
Thanks, Joseph. Okay, this is Roses. Y'all sing it with us, Paul. I don't know how well you know this song.
It's
the exact same the whole way through.
I get by, yeah.
Counter full of long stems that never seem to die. My favorite's the pale pink, but I'll settle for white. Looking at me, I'm drowning in Valentine. At least once a week, you got a dozen in hand. Doing what you think makes you a good man. And I'll flash that fake smile. And then the roses. I see what you did there. All right, my two people on YouTube, thanks for hanging with us.
You too.
Thank you so much, TikTok, for hanging with us. I am so happy to have you every Monday. Thanks for hanging for this special edition. Paul, how do you feel about your first Mayday Monday?
I can't even put it to words what this means to me. I would like to thank the Academy, my mom and dad, and of course, May Estes.
The preacher, the teacher, the farmer,
and the hookers all out there. No, I'm excited for the EP. I'm so proud to have worked on it, and May is literally one of my favorite people in the world. And to get to make music with her and be really good friends, it's just a cool thing to get to be part of.
Back at you, dude.
That's what I'll
Don't make eye contact with me when you say that. Yeah, we just are two kids that really love country music and music in general, and I think it's been our tool to survive a lot of life, and it's pretty cool when you get to celebrate it, you know, like, as your job. Does it still feel weird for you that it's your job?
Yep, every day.
He's been at it a lot longer than I have as far as professionally doing music, and I just feel like it's important to surround yourself with people who remind you that we literally get to live our dreams, because it gets a little messy in Nashville and you really got to find your people and hold on to them. So any advice you would give young artists, young writers, people who haven't gotten to where they want to be in their career yet?
Oh, that's for the beginning of this and not the last 30 seconds. But believe in yourself, persevere, and just kind of have gratitude for every little step of the way. And it, you know, because it's not easy, but if you keep a positive outlook, you can get through whatever. Just work. I don't know.
That's something you're great at, is being positive. Paul's really good at bringing positivity. I'm really good at acting like the world is on fire all the time. So we balance each other well in that. I would definitely say that too. I'm not where I want to be in my career, but I don't know that you ever are. I think you're always trying to grow and learn and push yourself to be better in anything you're doing, probably. But definitely finding your people is advice I have, because I feel like I would be nothing in this crucial time in my career without my people who have known me inside and out and know how to keep me grounded and know how to bring me back down once I start feeling like I'm spinning. Anyways, happy Mayday Monday. Thank y'all so much for hanging out with me. I hope you have a great Valentine's Day. If you need some anti-Valentines, I will be posting those on my Instagram tonight. I made some super funny poems that are very not romantic. and we can't wait for y'all to hear the EP. Please tag us, share any videos you're making. It makes us so excited. It's really, really cool to get to put it in your hands after we've worked so hard on it. Thank you to Paul for joining me on Mayday, producing my EP, woo-hoo, being such a great friend, and we have many, many more years of music making to do.
Let's
I got
go.
Anything to say about it.
Let's go.
Love y'all. Happy Valentine's Day. Mostly happy EP release week before the record this Thursday.
Woo!
See ya!
Peace.
And then YouTube gets to watch us.
And
look, yep. Awkward. I don't know how to end you, YouTube. Oh, I just see the...
Oh, there's the comments.
Oh, no.
Are we off or is it
no,
still?
No, we're still on here. Hey, YouTube, I'm so sorry. There were comments.
I'm the worst.
Hey, I'm sorry.
Hey, look at that. Is that still going?
Probably. We're still here. Okay. I'm going to end you now. Dang.
You had 996 viewers?
How do I see my chat? We love you. Thrift store heart. I'd rather raise a glass than a baby. Smoke on the water.